I'm going to close out tonight and share a story I share everywhere I go. And it was a story that Keith Biggs shared with me when I was a sophomore in high school at that Disciple Now weekend. And that story made such an impact in my life that I'll never forget it. And so I close every show with it because it made such an impact in my life. That little boy, he'd run up and down the beach. And as he'd run up and down the beach, he'd stop, he'd pick up something, he'd hold it in his hands, and he'd throw it into the water. One day he goes running down the beach and he's got a friend with him and they're running and he sees something and he stops and he picks it up, he holds it in his hands, looks at it, tosses it into the ocean. His friend doesn't say anything. Run down a little bit further, he does the same thing. Finally, the third or fourth time, his friend stops him and he says, "What are you doing? You keep stopping and starting. You're messing up our pace." And he bends down and he picks up something and he says, "You see this? It's a starfish. They get washed up on the beach, the tide goes out, the sun comes up, and it dries them out and they die. So I throw them back into the ocean so they can live." This friend kind of laughs and he says, "Man, look down the beach, there are hundreds of starfish. You're never going to make a difference." And his friend bent down and he picked up one more starfish, he held his hands and looked at his friend and said, "Did you see this one?" And he threw it into the ocean and he looked at his friend and he said, "It made a difference to that one. Tonight I will let you know that you make a difference to Jesus Christ. No matter what anyone has told you, he has a plan and a purpose for you." And the best way I know how to tell you what God did in my life is like this. Here we are, and here's God. And the Bible says that we're separated from God because of a thing called sin. And sin is anything that gets in the way of us and our relationship with Christ. Anything that gets in the way of us and our relationship with God is called sin. Yet we'll try to connect with God on our own. And we think, "Well, I'm a good person, so I'll go to heaven, or I go to the church, or I know all about the Bible." And we try to connect with God on our own. But the Bible makes it very clear. Jesus said, "I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." And remember I said God has a purpose for your life? This red handkerchief is going to represent Christ. And God came down to earth, God in the form of man. He walked up to people who couldn't see, and he would touch their eyes, they could see again. People who couldn't hear, he touched their ears, they could hear again. People who couldn't walk, he would say, "Get up." And they would get up and walk away. And they're going to crucify him, and they took him, and they tied him around a pole, and they stripped his clothes off, they spit on him, they beat him, they pulled his hair out. They took this long whip with pieces of leather coming off of it, with pieces of rock and stick tied to it. And when they whip him, those pieces of leather would wrap around his body. And those pieces of rock and stick would go into his flesh. And they would yank the whip off and literally tore the flesh off of his body. Then they nailed him to a cross. And they still mocked him. They said, "You're a king, you need a crown." And they shoved a crown of thorns into his head. And they left him there to die. They took him off the cross and they placed him in a tomb. This little bag is going to be his tomb. They took him off the cross and placed him in a tomb. And they left him there. They thought that's it, the end of the story. But when they went back, the tomb was empty. See, Jesus had risen from the dead. He was no longer in the tomb. So that in our lives, we're searching and searching for some truth. When we trust in Christ, we're no longer separated. But Jesus literally becomes a bridge across that gap called sin. We're able to have a relationship with God through Jesus Christ. He bridges that gap. And he desires to have a relationship with you the same way that he desired to have a relationship with me when I was a sophomore in high school. He doesn't care about your past. He doesn't care what your lifestyle has been like up until this point. He desires to have a relationship with you now. He loves you. He's got a plan and a purpose for you. Let's pray.